are back now with one of our favorite guests who always brings us something delicious. She is an incredible chef and the host of Food Network's Holiday Baking Championship. And now, this lady has written a children's book called Carla and the Christmas Cornbread. We're so glad to have you here.
I am so excited. I can't believe I have a children's book.
It's amazing. And I love the story. We're going to talk about it, but you're going to walk us through some actual cornbread. You came not only to talk about the book, you've got three must-do top baking tips. And I always get this one wrong, I never prep ahead of time to leave the ingredients out. So walk me through what has to be room temp, what has to stay cold.
So when you're doing cookies and biscuits and pie crust, that butter has to be cold. When you're doing cakes where the butter has to be creamed, that needs to be room temperature. And room temperature means your butter is bending and soft. It's not.
So I can't pop it in the microwave. It's not total liquid.
Oh my God, please don't do
that. Don't do that. No, sorry.
Okay,
fail.
So, but let's say it's last minute and you want to still do your butter. Get a grater. Grate your butter because this will actually help your butter come to room temperature so much
faster.
This
is blowing my mind.
Yeah.
This is a life-changing hack.
Right.
Look at this. This is why you're here.
This is
amazing.
This is why I'm here.
Okay, do you have to actually sift the flour?
You need to sift your flour before you measure it.
And it's
a must-do because if you don't sift your flour, it settles. You will have 1 or 2 tablespoons more of flour than you need. The balance, the ratio of dry to wet will be off.
Really,
and your cookies don't work, and you blame me for the recipe, and it's you. I'm just saying, it's you. So if your eggs are also cold, put them in warm water to make them room temperature.
Oh, for how long, roughly?
Until they actually feel like warm.
Yep. Okay.
Yep.
Prepping the pans, you've got a tip on this too?
Prepping the pans. Just butter on the bottom, parchment paper, just cut that little circle out, and then butter and flour.
Oh.
So that it'll pop out, but it also adds a little bit of flavor and color.
But the parchment paper is what, to get it out of the pan?
To get it out of the pan.
Okay.
Yeah. You don't want to leave your cake. You know how many times you've made a cake? Have you made a cake?
I have, but then it ends up stuck on the bottom, chunks, and then I try to cover it and then cover it with the frosting, and it's just a big old disaster. Mm-hmm. So we're going to make as we go here and talk about the book, Carla and the Christmas Cornbread. I love it. I love it. I love it all. Does this hit close to home? Is this a family recipe we're talking about?
It hits close to home because I loved my grandmother's cornbread. She would never make it until we were on the inside of the door. Even if we told her we're coming in 20 minutes, well, great, I'll start making that cornbread in 20 minutes. This is little Carla, the cornbread, and it's at Christmas time, and they end up making cornbread for Santa.
This is the cornbread you grew up eating, Chris,
yeah.
The cornbread you still make today?
Yeah.
And is this the cornbread we're making right now?
Yes.
You want to show me what
yes.
to do? All right, walk
so,
me through it.
So, Cecilia, you're going to do all of the wet ingredients.
Okay.
You have eggs, oil, and cream corn
Ooh.
And buttermilk.
So now, you use oil, not butter.
Yes, especially oil is going to make your cakes and cornbread moist.
Really?
Yes. When you think about the room temperature version of your fat, like look at this. If this goes room temperature, what happens? It's cold. That's going to be like not so moist.
And this is buttermilk?
That's buttermilk, yes.
That's another pro tip right there, right?
If you don't have butter, if you can't find buttermilk, sour cream and full fat milk.
Ooh.
Yeah, you're welcome, people.
I mean, look at all these tips
they're
we are getting
They're just falling
right
out
here.
Of me.
I mean, I can't even. Okay, so this is, we got this.
Yep, I'm going to add
You go there,
here. You come to me, actually.
Okay.
You come to me. Yeah, all in.
I'm really excited about this. Cornbread is one of my primary food groups in the holiday season.
Did you notice that there's no flour?
No flour.
So what does that mean?
Why is that?
You don't need it. It has all this fat. It's gluten-free.
Really?
It's just naturally gluten-free.
It is gluten-free.
I didn't make it for the gluten-free
too.
People.
But it happens to be gluten-free.
Yes.
And wow.
Then you heat your pans up.
So you say, you know, I'm used to seeing cornbread often in a kind of a Pyrex or a cake dish like that. You say you can do them smaller, too.
Yes. You can do them in a big skillet. You can do them in a smaller skillet. You can also do them in muffin tins.
And what is this amazingness right here?
This is cinnamon butter. You just need butter, cinnamon, powdered sugar.
Lay it on
me. Here, there you
Lay
go.
Lay it on me.
And then a little bit of almond extract or vanilla extract.
Come on. Come on.
I'm going to have some muffin with my butter.
Cinnamon butter. Come on. Congratulations.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for this.
Mm-hmm.
You guys need to make this. It's wonderful. You can get this recipe on goodmorningamerica.com. Carla's new book, Carla and the Christmas Cornbread, in honor to your grandmother. Be sure to check it out on Holiday Baking Championship, everybody. Mondays on Food Network and Discovery+.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.